A few hours after dawn, some children are still lying on the ground. The plastic bottles from which they sniff glue beside them. Other spaces are empty, with those youngsters having headed off to work, begging on the streets. They have been considered a menace to the society as they seem to hassle almost anyone for their daily bread.
Tunaombanga watu tu kwa barabara, unaomba mtu 10 anakupea ama unafanya kazi hapa Muthurwa.
You will see them huddled in piles atop heaps of trash in groups, holding on to small plastic bottles beneath their noses. They are sniffing glue, a thick industrial glue meant for shoe repair and upholstery. The glue is typically huffed out of empty plastic water bottles. It's highly addictive and a powerful neurotoxin. Kids get hooked as soon as they hit the streets, some as early as 8 years old. 5 years later, they're bubbling and foaming at the mouth like rabid dogs. Kevin Okomo's story is emblematic of most of the glue kids. Their parents die or abandon them, or they're spit out by poor families, hence fending for themselves.
Wazazi wangu wana uwezo. Utakuwa unafikiria watu nyumbani ile kinyo. Utakuwa umewasahau tu ile waache tu kama tu hivi.
So, why do they really sniff this time bomb?
Inatoa stress.
Probably there's some form of frustration, or maybe it's for just for leisure activities. And once there's probably a sort of frustration, this person starts to kind of fantasize about how I can end all these with just taking alcohol, because the alcohol will, or whatever drug will dull, so that the person will dull those kind of frustrative moods, so the person won't have to think so much about them and also get stressed.
For others like Edwin, the allure of the big city is what made them leave their rural areas, where traditional community ties have loosened, for cities, where they have more chance of surviving by begging, finding odd jobs or scavenging rubbish sites. James Njuguna, who went to the streets after his parents separated, hopes this cries reaches the government.
Glue is one of the most popular drugs among the 300,000 homeless children, with 60,000 of the children living in Nairobi.
Most inhalants act directly on the nervous system to produce mind-altering effects. Within seconds, the user experiences intoxication and other effects similar to those from alcohol, as Ms. Rachel Maina from Uzima Mental Health tells us.
Taking substance one or the other kind of changes the brain functions, like such that instead of the brain functioning it normally does, and depending on the environment within the brain, the environment tends to change to actually now chemical dependency.
There are a variety of effects that may be experienced during or shortly after use, including slurred speech, hostility, unconsciousness, hallucination, and delusions. Prolonged sniffing of these chemicals can induce irregular and rapid heartbeat and lead to heart failure and death within minutes. In Nairobi, many street kids inhale glue for a cheap high, and many of the dealers who sell them the glue are women. They are called mama pimas. We try to persuade them to lead us to the women, but they are afraid that they will be beaten. There is no official figure on the number of homeless children in Kenya, a sign of lack of interest by Kenyan authorities of the problem. But until relevant stakeholders come to the rescue of Kevin and his friends, Kenya continues to lose at an alarming rate a generation that is ripe for the betterment of the economy, but oftentimes ignored or overlooked. Oh, Maonyango. KUTV, Nairobi.